City Auditor.
Hello, my name is Denise Rapley. I'm a partner with Valenti Rapley and Associates. And our firm has been engaged to audit the city's financial statements for the year ended December 31st, 2015. Our professional standards require that we provide you certain information at the beginning of the audit, and also to tell you that if you have any desire to have a conversation or discussion, or if you have questions or need to provide information, we're certainly available for you. Those that have been here before have heard me say this, and this is your first time, so we'd certainly welcome any input that you might have on this audit. And as stated in our engagement letter, our responsibility, according to our professional standards, is to express opinions on whether your financial statements prepared by management with your oversight are fairly presented in all material respects in conformity with U.S. generally accepted accounting principles. Our audit of the financial statement does not relieve you or management of your responsibilities for those financial statements. Now, in this audit, we will be presenting required supplementary information, and that will consist of budgetary schedule for the general fund and pension schedules. And with these schedules here, we will apply certain limited procedures according to our standards, but these particular schedules will not be audited. So we will not provide an opinion on these schedules. We've also been engaged to report on the combining and individual non-major fund schedules, capital projects fund schedules, and the 1% special purpose sales tax cost schedule. And these, we will be reviewing these schedules and including a reporting on whether the supplementary information is fairly stated in all material respects in relation to the financial statement as a whole. Now, when we do the audit, we perform tests for, basically, we select certain items and we use our judgment and we look for evidence supporting the amounts and disclosures in the financial statement. Therefore, our audit will include judgment about the number of transactions to be examined and areas to be tested. We do obtain an understanding of your entity and your environment and your internal control, and we use these to design the tests that we're going to perform and in what areas we plan to work in. Generally, if we have any findings, we usually communicate those at the end of our audit procedure. But if there are some issues might come up during our procedures that we think are important, we will inform you of those sooner. We will also communicate to you at the end of the audit if we find any internal control issues that we think need to be addressed. We actually have already started our audit. Just started this past week. And actually, I met with Jonathan and Paula this morning to kind of get an overview of 2015. Now, we expect to issue our report no later than June 30th, but we are targeting the May 31st meeting for a draft for y'all to have. And so usually we get the report finalized before June 30th. If you have any questions, my information is on the, did everybody get a copy of the letter? Feel free to contact us, and we'll be the next couple weeks concentrating on this audit. So if you come in, you'll see some of us here working on the audit. Does anybody have any questions? Okay, thank you. We appreciate it.
Thank you.